Got a mansion, a condo, a cabin, I sleep in my Phantom. So high dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern, I ring your
session. I flushed it.
No, you didn't. Maybe today, not yesterday.
I had to flush that shit like four times.
It's recording. It's all good. You didn't flush your poop.
Fuck it.
They're
about to have a father-son argument right
just
now.
Just flush your poop.
Back on the coronavirus.
No, I'm tired of talking about
the coronavirus. Yeah, that's what I was trying to think about.
So, all right, if we're going to talk about the coronavirus, let's talk about this. Let's talk about what we're going to do while the coronavirus
to
is
counteract
putting us out.
It. Yeah. To what do we do?
Because honestly, I think we should go ahead and we might as well go ahead and do a live stream or some shit like that.
Yeah,
that'd be dope as fuck.
Because
you know what I mean?
Like
on Mondays we got we're supposed to wear some fucked up suit. like Fridays
like
we wear
casual.
Ron, you were talking about green screens.
Oh yeah, that'd have been dope.
We set up a green screen. We're all in front of the green screen. We could put any setting that we want behind us.
And we could be anywhere.
Are you saying for this?
Yeah.
That'd be dope.
Wait, this doesn't have to be plugged into anything, does it?
Nah, man.
No.
Let's just go out in the middle of the fucking woods. We should just start traveling every day and doing
set up the mics on a tree branch.
Random podcasts. I'm down.
Hey, look. Be going fishing and be like, oh shit, we got the right one.
I'm down. What the fuck else? I know that's. I was actually.
I'm about to go fishing.
So, before this actually happened today, where I lost my job and many other people did too, I was just gonna say we should.
Dude, I'm just laughing because you were so sure that you weren't shutting down, and in my head I was like, this motherfucker.
I just asked him yesterday. I was just talking to him yesterday. I was hey, y'all haven't closed, and he was like, nah, not yet. And I was like, it's probably gonna happen soon. And then today, I didn't find out until y'all. I was like, y'all didn't go to the gym.
Yeah.
Shit, I took me a nap while y'all were.
No, I mean, okay, so that was the shitty part. It was what do you tell people coming into a place that, they want to train? You're going to sign them up. That was my job to sign them up. Now it's I feel like a fucking idiot. Because
now you got to, basically apologize for...
Well, not apologize, but basically it's just, your account is on hold until X amount of time until we can open it back up.
But, I mean, that's not your fault, though.
No.
They knew that, going into it.
Yeah, there was a possibility.
But I feel like, regardless, they're going to try to, not put it on you, but try to get something out of it when the gym opens back up.
Oh, yeah. I want my money
back. We're in such, a customer, driven, world.
You
just
have
crazy.
To take care of the customer first and foremost, or else there's going to be repercussions on the business.
Yeah,
it's always like that. I don't know why.
They can make
the
biggest complaint.
We've had that happen too.
Dude, I consider the gym as my second home, honestly.
It's just sad because they praise you can get verified or whatever on Yelp, and then your review counts five times as much, you know what I'm saying? It's just fucking dumb.
Well, and the stupid thing is, it's if you only have one and it's a bad review, you're only if it's a bad review your first time, then there's only one, it's a one star, and that's what people see. So
I can't stand people who go to like when somebody's going to eat or something, and then they hop on, first thing they do is hop on Yelp, or going to do something, then they hop on Yelp to see reviews and shit. I can't fucking stand that.
I'm good with reviews, but I just want to know the names of places in that area. I'll go to Yelp to find out restaurant names, but I'm not gonna look at the reviews and be
instead of going to the you can't just go somewhere and just take the experience for what it is. You got to try to read somebody else's experience.
And then that
decides whether you go or not. Looking at the menu and shit. And it's just dude, just go and then fucking figure it out, bro.
Yeah,
it's not
and
that
then go
fucking,
from there, yeah. I just usually go for name, okay, what's in the area? I can go here. Let me go ahead and go. And then I go from there.
Exactly. Screw whatever. Everyone tastes everything different. Just go try it, man.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Read the damn reviews.
Yeah, because Google basically partnered with Yelp, I feel because they got the... like when you go to the maps, they got the pictures, and then if you click the picture, then I gotta download fucking Yelp, you know. So I'm like, I don't even use
Yelp.
I was like, I refuse.
Who that? But anyway, yeah, no, I agree. It's like times like this where it's like I feel like you have to be creative with like what you do have. I mean, I don't know if that, you know, whether it's
this just in.
Go back to work.
I wish.
Players cleared. Coronavirus is fake.
Coronavirus is fake.
But yeah, no, like hey. I said, right now, I think that'd be fucking funny as hell. Like just to do like a like right now. I mean, we could do it every day. Like go fucking podcast on the.
It's every day, bro.
I found the coolest spot, favorite spot in Arizona, like the other day.
We're at
in that park next to the library, just right down the road.
Yeah. Where the fuck is the library, man?
It's right down. It's literally like just go here, right like down. Here. You take a right, go all the way down like 2-3 miles, and then take a left. It's that huge, giant grass area, but you can't really see anything. You go back, there's 3 freaking lakes. It's so cool. It's the most beautiful hike or walk that I've done. And there's one section.
And it's just down the street.
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
it'd be a dope little podcast. You got the lake right behind us.
What's it called?
I don't know.
Oh my god, this motherfucking man.
I wouldn't explore.
How you like the pear? I think the pear was one of the better flavors.
Yeah, it's pretty.
You know, it don't really. It don't really taste
seltzer,
like.
This is the cure. It's the cure.
Beer?
No, it's the cure.
Beer.
Beer is the cure.
Cure.
No,
cure?
It's not beer. It's seltzer. That's the cure.
Cure.
Alka-Seltzer.
For beer. Beer for the cure.
Spiked. Just like your coffee.
I might have to get me a bottle of whiskey. My anxiety went through the roof today.
Yeah, let's make some.
What's your opinion on anxiety?
It's a real fucking thing.
Have you had anxiety, Gabe?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
That's why I was like, I'm gonna get a bottle of whiskey.
But I mean,
like, whiskey dump,
bro. Like, is that a good way to deal with like anxiety?
You know, no, but when you can't fucking go to the gym, like this is why. Okay, this push is why I feel like, yeah. I mean, I'm gonna fucking do
50
that.
50 told me and do I'm, sit-ups, and get
and
buff.
I'm gonna do.
Did 2.5? Couldn't get up.
It's like tomorrow. Yeah, most likely we will not be, like today's my off day, so it's all right. Like I understand. Like
no off days, bro.
I wasn't working out today. Anyway,
no off days.
There's an off day.
No, there's an off day.
Yeah, right, anyway, for me there was today. but tomorrow I'm gonna be doing push-ups or whatever the fuck I need to be doing. You know, go for a run, sit-ups. To keep my mind and my body in check.
Do some pistol squats.
Right now is not a good time fucking for pussy. The world socially and mentally and physically.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's like, if you cut off, like, I get it. You want to, like, slow this, whatever it is, down. Here we are talking about this shit again.
Yeah, what the fuck is
if,
this?
If you...
Rico's toys, man.
Oh, okay.
If you slow this down by, like, not having people go to gyms, yeah, it'll go away. But at the same time, people...
I feel like it'll just keep it here because people aren't doing nothing.
Yeah, like, it's still going to be in the house or whatever. Yeah. But like, or wherever you're at.
Yeah.
Like, unless you literally live by your... I don't know. It just... I don't know.
I feel like it's like keeping people boxed in, like stagnant, like not doing, scared to
live.
I think like scared more than anything.
Life,
yeah.
Yeah. And it was like, you know, you've got to stay active, like in this world.
Woke.
Exactly. Woke too.
There's some young people that are woke and it kind of freaks me out.
I fuck with Eric, man. Eric's funny.
But those are like, yeah, if you're woke and what did you say?
So there's some young people in this world that are woke.
Yeah,
it's just
because
like,
they've probably experienced a lot of hardship from day one.
What? So you guys are older now. So what would you go back and tell your 16-year-old self?
Huh. Buy toilet paper.
I would probably tell myself never to smoke, man. Never to get addicted to nicotine.
Is that when you got? Or is that when you started smoking?
No, I started smoking when I was 18. But I would go back and tell myself like when I'm 16, it's like, yo, don't mess around with that shit. It's not good. Start working out. I didn't start working out when I was 16, man.
So
I was just chilling.
You did or didn't?
I didn't.
See, no. I started working out when I was 16, and that's been a foundation of my life for the last 10 years. And I'm grateful for it. So it's like when shit like this happens, and I'm not the only one. Like when you get into a, like whether it's working out playing tennis, shooting hoops, going for a run, and you start cutting that source off to people, it's not good mentally.
You know what I was doing when I was 16? I didn't find that escape, man. Music was my escape, but also donuts, dip, and Minecraft was another escape.
Donuts, dip, and Minecraft.
Dodge, duck, dip, dive, and dodge.
2 liters of bottles of Mountain Dew. It's all jacked up.
Jesus, dude. You're all jacked up on Mountain Dew, man? What? Oh, like, so that was that when you were, like, a bigger kid?
Yeah.
Is that that's the scubby stage we were talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scummy or scubby?
Scubby.
What's scubby?
Little bit of both.
I was a greasy scubby. Hair, didn't shower for a week. You're
like, hey, when be, you're like I'm, skinny, I'm, but.
I might be going back to that stage.
When you're like here. Skinny, like, but.
You got to fend for yourself. You got to do what you got to do. I might be a little scubby here soon.
When you're skinny, but like chubby.
Yeah.
Chubby, but
I was
skinny.
I like that before I started looking playing like, sports.
A Monsters, Inc., a little green fella. Skinny arms.
Yeah, is his name?
Mike?
Yeah,
Mike,
yes.
Mike Wazowski.
I thought it was Kwasowski. Yeah, yeah. What?
I got a pee timeout on my section.
Oh, well, dude, you got to give the people, you got to tell them your 16-year-old self.
Spike Seltzer, I got a pee. It went right through me. And I'll tell you later.
He's got a baby bladder.
Put on hold.
I got a baby bladder. I had a lot of urine today.
What?
I got a lot of
what
water.
The fuck? Okay. Yeah, yeah. Why don't you just go pee,
man? Bro.
Get the fuck out of here.
Pull a get smart. Gotta squeeze the lemon. Get a what?
Holy shit.
You're gonna make
hey,
bread?
Ron, what would you tell your 16-year-old self? That's the topic currently.
Oh, shit. Let me get on here.
Strap up.
What would I tell my 16-year-old self? Okay. Honestly, right now, I think I would tell my 16-year-old self is just to continue to push on and be consistent. I feel like at that time, like, that was like, a big problem of mine. And so I got to the point to where, like, I just gave up, in a sense. And so, like, that's where my, like, downside started to happen a little bit. And so then, like, my senior year, like, I really didn't even go to school. Like, it was over with. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so I just feel like, you know, with that being my 16-year-old self, I just tell myself to be consistent and to continue to follow my dreams.
Yeah, consistent in everyday life. Follow one thing and just don't give up on it.
How does one become consistent?
Routine.
Honestly, I don't think it's just routine. I just believe it's just continuously following after it. You know what I mean? Like you, it doesn't matter. You don't have to do it every day in the morning. You don't have to do it every day at night. But
it's every day, bro.
But it's every day. You see what I'm saying? you see what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't have to be like exactly that time in the morning.
But at
some point in the day when you get it, you're still doing it.
Just
but
like
that's every day.
Just like the gym.
Your boy's back. No more seltzer in my system.
So, your turn?
Your 16-year-old self, Ron just shared.
Slight recap. I missed it.
What? Consistency?
Consistency. Yeah.
Dodge, duck, dip, dive, and dodge.
Just be you.
I don't like dodge.
Just be you. I mean,
people. You got to elaborate, man.
Be you, you know? tell how it is.
That's you. That's your. Man,
advice to your
16-year-old
self?
Yeah.
Your 16-year-old self would be lost by that.
Be you?
Mm-hmm. Be
why?
You. I mean, that can mean a lot of things.
Yeah, you gotta.
Especially for
your
16-year-old self.
Because you're not your 16-year-old self anymore. Be you.
Like, you have a different mind than your 16-year-old self. So
be
like,
honest, be loyal, be truthful. Like, just stick to your morals and roots.
Mm. Anything specific you would.
There's nothing that happened or whatever that's kind of like
changed.
Or do you guys not really believe in that, like the regrets thing?
I mean, I have regrets. I mean, I feel like it's I don't know how the saying always go, but it's like something about
no regrets. Forget,
forgive and forget or something like that.
Yeah,
like,
forget, but don't forget
or something like that.
But you can't let your past like hinder.
God forgives, I don't. Shout out Rick Ross.
But I mean, even with your like with that whole situation, what you're saying, like with your past, don't let it hinder you. Like your past is what makes your future.
Yeah, it does.
You see what I'm saying? But it's something that's where it's like, you know, you can't forget your past to know who you are for the future.
I guarantee. Yeah.
Even so that's what the whole saying, I think.
Even though if I came back to myself 16 years old and I told myself, don't do this, that was last year. Yeah, thanks. I would still make those same mistakes.
Flush the toilet. Don't get them poo particles in your beard.
Oh, God, here we go.
Still make those same mistakes because I never learn unless I've actually been through it.
What, getting
like my even my brother, for example, he's always given me advice, but I made the same mistakes as he did. And I didn't truly learn from it until I experienced it.
But I mean, I feel like it'd be different when it's coming from yourself, though. When you're able to go look back and look at yourself in the face.
Shout out, Rico.
Fucking Rico. Yeah,
Rico but hold on. No, you got to listen to this.
Yeah, sit the fuck down.
Okay. Rico will be all right. But, like, to look at yourself in the face, like, to go back and, like, to have your little face. You ain't had no facial hair when you were 16.
Nah.
Okay, then. So, you just looking back at yourself and you just, like, actually, like, damn, like, this is what I'm going to look like when I'm 21. 20 what? 22.
22?
So, it's, like, it's one of those things where it's, like, it's something that's direct to you. So, it's, like, even for myself, I go back and I can look at myself today and be, like, damn, I probably listen to that motherfucker more than I listen to the other motherfucker that's been telling me this shit all these years. You know what I mean? That motherfucker coming from the future. Shout out Back to the Future.
I love that show.
That's a movie, bro.
Well, huh? It's a series.
Back to the Future?
I call everything a show, okay? That's a movie. It's a show.
Back to the Future?
A movie.
What's it about?
What?
What?
What's it about?
You've been living under a rock?
You know,
this is
Gabe.
Him telling you that.
Yeah, I don't know.
you know Gabe live under the rock. Gabe don't watch nothing besides cartoons and hood movies.
I told you.
Hey, have you ever seen
I just watched a hood rat show with my friends.
South Central.
Oh, Don't Be a Menace?
No. It's the movie South Central.
Oh, the movie South Central.
Where,
if it was on BET, like, growing up, I probably did.
Well,
because they would always show. BET. Yeah, they would have, like,
the little boy got shot in the back with a shotgun because he was stealing radios.
I don't know.
Well, that's harsh. That's a harsh punishment.
That's a good one. Yeah. Hey, watch that. That's what he talked about. He's like, he was in there, I think he got shot. They're playing ping pong. He's in there playing. She was like, "No, what's wrong with you?" She was like, "Man, I don't want to play no motherfucking honky ball." And after a while, he was in that boy like pat 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 beating everybody.
Oh yeah, he just took over the honky ball.
I would have called that from now on.
Honky ball. What, like, is it ping pong?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Honky ball.
Ping pong's cool, man. I fuck with ping pong.
I hate when people get too competitive in ping pong.
What do you mean? Got to win.
Yeah.
It's like. Same goes with basketball, man. It's like, I like to play basketball. I love the sport. But when people get really competitive, and then when you start making shots by pure luck, and you see the guy who's way better than you get really pissed off and depressed, and he starts, like, getting angry and starts throwing the ball and throwing a fit, and it's like, it's not fun anymore.
I mean, that can be any sport, though.
Yeah, it can. Yeah,
it's true.
People are, like, little shitheads.
I just think that's competition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't do a competition.
There's friendly competition.
Yeah, but
friendly competition is good.
But you're saying through your experiences, it's not like a rec league or some shit. You know what I'm like? You're just picking up for basketball.
Fun.
Yeah, at the gym or something, and then people just get.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I don't ever play at the gym, man. Because I ain't.
Yeah, you just want to shoot. And
I ain't dealing with these fucking douchebags. You know.
I get buckets on them, then I go play racquetball.
Yeah, and we can't even play racquetball right now. God,
I know,
damn,
man. I'm
April 1st, baby.
I'm on a 3-game win streak. I believe.
Is that when they said they're going to open back up?
I think
three,
so, yeah.
Yeah.
One, two, three. Once April 1st comes, it's over for you bitches.
What, to play racquetball?
Nah, I ain't playing racquetball.
Come on,
you guys,
pussy bitch.
Man, come on. We can play fourth.
Nah,
that's what I'm saying.
I ain't playing racquetball.
Why?
I mean, I'll play.
You know? Racquetball's
bad out. You're just not predicting yourself.
Play,
so,
no,
man, I'll play.
We can play four.
So what is it?
We can definitely play four.
I'm just not going to go out of my way to play, that's all. You know?
We'll drag you to it.
So. I mean, like, we'll all be in the same building, you know? It's not like...
But
it's,
I mean,
it's not like it won't
okay,
happen,
so
but I'm just saying I'm not going to
you see how
go
big
to
the court
gym
is,
and
though.
Then just...
Oh, so yeah. It's not like you're going to be doing too much moving around. Now, if you play twos, that's different. But with four people, you're not going to move that. It's just you and your partner.
Yeah. I don't know, man. I mean, it's kind of like baseball, you know? I just kind of got scared of the ball, so I was like, I ain't playing this shit no more.
Gabe don't like no balls.
Yeah, man. No balls to the face, dog. Ain't nobody just, yeah, I'm not going to stand, I'm not gonna stand in a box and let this man just throw 100-mile-per-hour fucking fastball at my fucking dome, dog.
And hope he can hit his square.
Yeah, I'll kill this motherfucker. Yeah.
I mean, I can understand that, but racquetball different.
Yeah,
but it's the same because you're just smacking this damn ball. It's going like 90.
It's two. It's two different type of balls.
Now we got four grown ass dudes just rolling around in this fucking.
I got hit in the face with those balls. Around,
in this room, you know.
You get hit in the face with balls, bro.
Yeah, I don't know.
Ricochet,
man. And then we're all like running into each other and shit.
Have you ever?
Then somebody gets smacked with a racquetball.
Have you ever played?
No.
I don't know, man. It just looks like a lot going on.
I said the same thing until I got in there, and I was like, God damn, this shit fun as hell.
And it's like, it's easy cardio that you literally don't even know you're doing, just because you're
like,
so
just for one point, you'd be like, hey, we're here for 10 minutes.
It's hot.
I'm going to do Zumba instead.
Zumba.
You do Zumba instead of racquetball.
No, I'm just kidding, man. I'm just starting a lot of shit right now.
No, but racquetball is a good workout, like sweat.
Oh yeah!
I was drenched. Like I'm talking about, my whole damn shirt was sweaty. I'm like, God damn!
All test.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, man. I mean, I guess we won't know till we know. You know?
Yeah, it might be.
Because it might not be ever.
Might be fucking 5 months.
Yeah, we gotta wake up tomorrow.
Might have to build our own racket court.
That would be a fun.
We gotta find one of them outdoor ones.
They have outdoor racquetball courts.
Yeah, here's a game. We had a wall with a whole bunch of holes in it. You try to like hit the ball through the holes.
Yo, have you guys seen that axe throwing thing?
Oh yeah,
that shit looks fun though.
Drinking beer and throwing axes.
Yeah, yeah,
that sounds dangerous.
Definitely a bad mix.
There's one in Westgate. I think there's probably one in Tempe too.
There's a couple.
Yeah, I'll check that out sometime. I mean, no time soon.
Sounds like a lot of fun. Yeah, I don't have money to spend on that.
No, I'm pretty much quarantining myself right now.
Yeah, this shit's crazy.
Well, that's crazy. I mean, it's like, yeah, it's one thing where, like, I feel like this 2 week stint or whatever the fuck, however long it is going to be, is like, oh, you know, there's people that are like your governors and your politicians and your higher end people, you know, that don't have to struggle. This is a fucking vacation for them.
Like, yeah, I mean, they're chilling.
Yeah.
There's like, a beneficial thing about it.
It does. What?
Something beneficial.
Well, I mean,
no, I'm saying for them, this is not beneficial.
Well, I mean,
for any of us.
So how about this? If you're jealous of those people and how they can kind of just like kick back during this time, like why don't you try to be one of them?
I mean, I'm not saying that I don't want to be. I'm saying that they've been most of them probably are probably, you know, 30 plus, 30 to 50, and are like can, you know, have
a lot of them not.
Not. What do you mean?
A lot of them aren't 30 to 50. A lot of them are around the same age as us. You know what I mean? And that's how I always like look at it. Like, look at the there's a 14. Like I always talk about this. There's a 14-year-old girl. What's her name? She played in the movie. She wrote the movie and she played in the movie.
Well,
played
damn.
In the movie, and she was 14.
Starting off a good start.
Something Jackson. She was on
Percy
like
Jackson.
Disney. No,
Who the fuck is Percy Jackson?
You trying to watch a movie later, bro? No, we got all the time in the world right now.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I got shit to do.
I'm talking about the girl's name. Her last name is Jackson.
Sky Jackson.
I think it's Sky Jackson.
What? But who's her parents? Who's her parents?
Nobody.
Are you sure?
I'm sure her parents is nobody. She's the one. She basically like pays the bills and shit now.
Okay. But
she came up through Disney. She started in Disney.
Well, shit, I can't even get into Disney. Right.
Well, I want to know who her parents are, because like a lot of people don't pay attention to like little shit like that. Like even the one girl that's on.
Oh, are you saying like they're like her?
They're like, born and they already have a foot in.
Yeah, like
I see what you're saying.
Like
Jaden and
I mean,
and
fuck off, fuck all them.
Exactly.
But
anyone with a predecessor parent who had already been.
So people don't even realize. I guarantee that. Look here. Because I'm curious.
No, that's a good point though.
It's that show, Arrested Development. I think it's something like that. But there's a girl, I think her name's Rashida Jones. That's fucking Quincy Jones's daughter, bro.
Yeah, so obviously
like one of the biggest dudes in the music industry.
So she already like had she an
yeah, and it's fucking
so
crazy.
It's like for your everyday average citizen who's trying to make it into a certain industry compared to someone who is like a child of someone else.
Yeah.
There's but it's contrast.
Yeah, like, there's even Lenny Kravitz's daughter is big right now. And it's Lenny Kravitz's daughter.
Like not to say that they that they might not have put in work, but it's I feel like their avenue was a lot easier.
Yeah, it's 100 times easier. There ain't even a
comparison. Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I'm just curious who the parents are. And then like that, it's not that that parent has to be like famous, but if they got some sort of fucking
connection, mom.
Oh fuck!
Ah shit!
Kaya Cole.
I don't know.
So American Instagram star.
Everybody, American Instagram star.
Right.
Man, I was just looking at this. You guys keep talking.
Instagram. Yeah, which is, I mean, mainly for me, it's just like age doesn't play a role in a lot of things. I mean,
it's not as important as
honestly you make it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so, like, if you make it to where it's like, okay, this is when I'm supposed to do this at this certain age, then that's when you're gonna do this shit. And you might be later than that because you're planning on it at that time. It's like everything is always where it's like, you know, you can do everything at any time. Like, I was in a sense where I was kind of reverse shit. I was taking care of brothers and sisters at fucking second grade. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I was already doing
but it should, but it should be the opposite,
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. And so, like, you know,
no,
for
a
lot of people, it's
just the cards that are dealt to you.
Yeah, but I'm just saying this to where, like, you know, it's just far as, like, learning stuff. So it's like, you know, when it comes to where, like, you know, say with her, she just was like, oh, I'm interested in this and started doing it. And it was just like, oh, I'm going to write out it. This is a... like a screenplay or something, and then was like, oh, hey, mom, read this. And then my mom sent it off or some shit. You see what I'm saying? It's just like, that's how a lot of that shit happens. So that's where it comes to where it's like, people need to be putting out shit. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. To where it's like, you know, you got to get out there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Agreed. I don't know. I mean, after reading that, I'll take it with a grain of salt. But that's cool, though. Shout out to Sky. Is it Sky Jackson?
Yeah, Sky Jackson.
Yeah.
Sorry, Miss Jackson. I didn't mean to make your daughter cry.
Oh,
I am for real.
He sounded like he was at a.
I need to like cut that, and make that like the intro, just like. What
yeah,
the
he was
fuck?
Like. He sounded like he was at a poet reading.
Yeah.
He's like,
just like monotone,
sorry,
just
Miss Jackson.
Just no emotion. Yeah. Have you guys ever been to one like one of those or like a comedy show?
I've been to
a comedy show.
I've been to a poet reading night.
I haven't been to a poet reading night. That'd be dope.
Oh man, I was watching a comedy on Netflix last night. I mean, fucking laughing until like 1 o'clock in the morning.
I heard you.
Some female comedy act.
Was it the?
Yo, did you hear the fucking helicopter over the house too?
No.
Or around here? I don't know. It was. Like 3 o'clock in the morning.
Somebody's on the run, man.
Nah, I didn't hear that. We're gonna get broken into.
Nah, man, it's a gated community, man.
Nah,
no one can get in here.
We got guns. We got 8 guns.
Them guns.
No, but what were you saying? The fucking comedian?
Oh yeah, man. She was talking to she was
fucking blowing it, man. Fucking blowing it.
She's just she talks about like it was interesting to watch because she was talking about guys and then what her perspectives of what hot looks like.
Mm-hmm.
It was like as for the opposite sex watching this, it was very interesting and you got to learn a lot about how females work. Honestly, like their thought process.
I mean, there is no thought process.
It's crazy.
Yeah, they don't know what they want.
Yeah. Well, was it the Asian lady?
No.
I'm trying to think of which one it was.
Some 22-year-old chick.
Oh.
She's pretty cute.
Oh, the white. Was she blonde?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I know which one you're talking about then. Yeah. I don't know, man. I think everybody should go to a comedy show, though. That was a good time.
Which one did you go to?
It was at Cityscape. Or Stand Up Live, I mean.
In Phoenix?
Downtown, yeah. I don't know who the guy was, but it was good. It was cool.
I seen Mike Epps.
Oh, Mike Epps? Mike Epps would be cool.
Yeah, that was dope.
Where was it at?
I've heard
in Huntsville.
I've heard Tempe Improv is good.
Yeah, yeah. They do like open mic on Tuesdays, I think, or some shit.
Well, probably not right now.
And on Tuesday they lost. I mean, yeah, it wasn't even a fucking job. They didn't even have no job.
And the cricket noises rolled in.
Yeah, that's crazy.
But yeah, I think on keep hustling. We gotta be creative as much as we can and focus on.
Maybe we could hit this again in a couple hours. Yeah, yeah.
We gotta live life for a little bit.
Yeah, so, yeah, yeah. All right, man, it's been real.
Shout out, Parrot Elderflower. Time for a quick nap, and we'll see you in a few.
Yeah.
Taylor Tomlinson.
Yep.
That was her name.
Shout out!
All right, world. Hey, stay alive. And don't catch things.